In this video, we'll build a dynamic budget tracker like this, which will tell us our income, our expenses, and our savings alongside some supporting visuals. And all of this is going to be automatically calculated using our inputs tab, where you'll be able to input your income or your expense sources. So let's get into it. Looking at the Excel file, which you can download in the video description for free, you can see here under the dashboard tab that we've got the income breakdown by each specific month alongside the year-to-date total on the very end. And the same thing goes for the expenses. You can see we have different sources here. And lastly, we have the savings towards the bottom alongside some supporting visuals that we'll add later here. Let's take a closer look at the inputs tab. So over here, you can see that we have all of these categories, which are basically some the income, while others are gonna be the expenses that we can record. And so over here, we have some dummy data where you've got, say in the month of January, some of the typical expenses that you might have. In this case, it's a Metro card, and you can select that dropdown and pick up the one that you prefer most. Now, if you go to control down arrow all the way to the bottom here, I'm just going to show you how you can add a new item. So first, we'll just copy the one from above. So control C there, and then just paste it down over here, control V, like so. Now let's suppose this date is actually in September. Let's say I picked the 2nd of September, like so. Then you can see this is gonna auto-populate, and we can select whatever category we want. Let's say this is our investments, and say this is our stock dividends. And from here, let's say we just put the amount that we want at 300. Now, one thing to note is that sometimes you might have duplicates. For instance, in September, maybe you went to a grocery store more than once. That's okay, that's something you can add multiple times as well. And if you don't really want this dummy data, you can always go ahead and start deleting it by hitting shift space, and then control minus, like so. Now that we know how to add an income or an expense, let's move up to the dashboard tab. As you can see right now, we don't have any of the amounts, so let's work to make it dynamic. So we're just gonna go equals, sum ifs, hit the tab key when you find that, and this is going to calculate all of the inputs that we want, and more specifically, we want them to be, in this case, in the month of January for the base salary. As we move along, we want it to update to the month of February base salary, and as we move down, we also want it to update, say, February for investments, and so on and so forth across the whole sheet. So the sum ifs formula is gonna allow us to do that. Now the sum range for us is all of the amounts. So under the inputs tab, we're simply gonna select a whole column. So just click on that F there, and you can see that that's gonna start to show up. Then one important thing we need to do is hit the F4 key. You'll notice that's gonna put some dollar signs in front of the letter. That basically says that, hey, as we move this along across all of the different months, this column is gonna stay fixed here, which is what we want. We don't want it moving along or there's not gonna be any numbers. Hit the comma key there, and here it's gonna ask for the criteria range. So the first criteria is that we want this month to be equal to the month that we're seeing in the dashboard tab. So this is the whole range for us, the column C. Hit the F4 key again, comma, and then the criteria number one, let's go back to the dashboard there, is first that we want it to be in the month of January. Now for this, we actually do want it to move to the side, but just we don't want it to go down when we copy the formula across. So we're actually gonna press the F4 key, not once, but actually hit it twice there, like so. Hit the comma key, and now we have the second criteria range, which we want it to be under the income, right? So in this case, the base salary. So under inputs, we're gonna go to the categories, which is what we want here. Hit the F4 key again, comma, and then the criteria number two for us, let's go back to the dashboard tab, is actually just gonna be the base salary. And again, we need to lock this one correctly. So press the F4 key three times on this occasion, such that it's only on the column. Then we can just close that formula and hit enter. And so we have for January, a base salary of 3,500. And let's move this across. So go to shift and then right arrow all the way to the very end there. And you're just gonna press control R, that should fill it across, and then shift down arrow and just press control D. We'll do the same thing with the expenses. So let's just copy that first one, control C. And then from here, go to shift down arrow and shift right, and then go to control V. And you can see that all the data is gonna start to auto-populate. And you remember in September, we went ahead and added 300 in investments, in stock dividends. Now you can see that that's showing over here. Now that we have all the numbers updating dynamically, let's work to calculate the totals. So for the total income, it's just gonna be the sum of these. So we'll use a shortcut by hitting shift right arrow all the way to the end there and alt equals, like so. Same thing goes for the expenses below. So shift right arrow and hit alt equals. And for the savings, it's simply the total income minus the total expenses, hit enter, and let's press shift right arrow to move that across, and then control R. Great, then we gotta work on the totals over here, which are simply the same thing. So it's just sum, hit the tab key there, and it's gonna be the sum of all of these, and hit enter. Let's drag that down, so control C, and then shift down arrow, and we only wanna paste the formula, not the format, because it's gonna mess up this bottom format here. For this, just go to Control Alt V, and we only wanna paste the formulas. So we're just gonna select that second one. As you can see, you can just go down arrow for that. Hit okay there, that's looking like it. This last part for the month-to-month growth, we don't want, so we'll just delete. Same thing goes over here, let's copy that one again, and then shift down arrow all the way to here, and then Control Alt V, and formulas again. So down arrow once and hit enter there. And this very last one, we're just gonna equal sum, and let's just select them like so. Close those brackets and hit enter. And speaking of Excel models, if you're liking this video, you can also check out our range of courses, which include Excel, PowerPoint, finance and valuation, as well as bundle packages. And what makes our courses different is that they're all applied to the real world. So aside from teaching the theory, our lessons also offer case studies that simulate the type of work you might be assigned in our day-to-day, ranging from creating a financial model on Excel to creating a slide deck presentation on PowerPoint. And if you get stuck along the way, you can easily ask us questions in the discussions forum. So if you're interested in checking it out, go to the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Another thing that would be nice to know is our growth trends. So is the income progressing as the year goes on? How about the expenses, etc.? Now to do that, we're gonna calculate the month-to-month percentage growth over here. So for February, we're just gonna go to equals the total income in February divided by the total income in January minus one, hit enter there, and then go to shift right arrow as we drag that along and control R. But you'll notice here towards the end that we start to get this error sign. That's basically because we have no data. So let's actually set up a conditional formula here that's gonna allow us to still work with all of this stuff. So at the very beginning here, we're just gonna create an if statement. Once you see that if, hit the tab key there. The logical test is basically if this cell over here equals zero, meaning that there's nothing in it, hit the comma key. If that's the case, then we actually don't want anything. So we're just gonna put two quotations like that. That basically tells Excel that we don't want anything. And if it's not the case, meaning that there is something, then we just wanna leave it as is because we wanna calculate the percentage. Close those brackets and then just hit enter there. And then when we go to shift right arrow and control R, you notice that we don't have all of these error signs here anymore. Then we can just copy this formula down. So control C, down over here, we're just gonna go to control alt V. And again, we only wanna paste formulas. Same thing over here. So shift right arrow and then control alt V, formulas only, hit enter. Moving on to step three, where we'll focus on the visuals. So first up, under the month-to-month growth, we can see here that maybe for the positive percentages, we can color them in green and red for the negative ones. To do so, first, let's select them. So select the entire row, control shift right there. Then we'll just go to conditional formatting, and then we're gonna create highlight cell rules greater than. So whenever it's greater than zero, we want it to be in green. So go on the dropdown, go to custom format, and we wanna select the font color to be in green. So let's go for this bright green like so, and then just hit okay there. Hit okay again. Now you can see that we have it in green for the positives, and let's work on the negatives now. So conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, less than. So less than zero, we want them to be in red. So the red text is actually this one over here, and hit okay. Now we just need to replicate this for the savings and the total expenses. So let's select it, control C, And then we're just gonna paste it over here under the savings first. So Control V there, and let's change the coloring there. So go to Alt HH. We're just gonna select the yellow color that I used to have and hit enter there. Now for the expenses, the reason I didn't do it just yet is because it's slightly different. In this case, if it's a negative, that's actually a good thing in that you spent less money, right? So we're actually gonna create some custom conditional formattings. So go to Control Shift right there, under conditional formatting. This time it's gonna be the reverse. So for greater than, it's gonna be when it's greater than zero, that's gonna be a negative thing. So we're gonna put that in red text, hit okay. And then when it's less than zero, it's a positive thing. So conditional formatting again, highlight cell rules, less than zero, and we're gonna put those in green. So under custom format font, we're gonna select the green, like so, and hit okay. Hit okay again, and that makes sense in that whenever the expenses go down, that's gonna be a positive thing. Now for the rest of the visuals, if you keep scrolling down over here, you can see that we have the income breakdown and the expenses breakdown. So we want to essentially create a pie chart. For it, first we'll select all of the income types, so shift down arrow. Make sure you press the control key there, and we're just going to select the year-to-date totals. So all of these here, then go to insert, and then we can go under recommended charts, and it should be that second one for you. Hit OK there. Let's work on reformatting it a bit. You don't really need that title, so we'll remove that. The legend here, let's say we want to put it on the left hand side. So go to right click, format legend, and let's say we put that towards the left. And for the colors, it's as simple as selecting one. So make sure only one is selected there. And under format, we're just going to change the shape fill to say a dark blue, like so. Let me fast forward how I change the colors of these other ones. Let's suppose we're happy with these colors. Then we want to remove that border as we're going to put it to the bottom there. So fill, we actually don't want a fill, and we don't want a border either, so no line. Let's go ahead and drag that down. And one final thing you can do here is once you select them, go to right click and add data labels. That's going to give you the labels like so. If you can't really see some of them, you can go ahead and select it and change the color of it to white, say. Same thing over here. Let's say we change that to a white. Let me fast forward how I do the same thing for the expenses, as you already know how to do it. Great, now with this budget tracker we just built, in the inputs we can always add any income or expense, and then over on the dashboard we're gonna be able to see the monthly breakdown alongside the growth trends and some visuals to support it. For more on Excel, check out this video over here to create a stock portfolio dashboard, or this other link over here to take some of our courses. Hit that like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.